हेलो। सो माय टुडेज़ टॉपिक इज़ विल माय ट्विन फ्लेम एक्सेप्ट माय बेबी। एंड दिस वीडियो इज़ ओनली एप्लीकेबल टू पीपल लाइक टू द ट्विन फ्लेम्स हु आर लाइक मैरिड एंड हैविंग ए चिल्ड्रेन एंड आइदर केस मे बी देयर ट्विन फ्लेम इज ऑल्सो मैरिड and or maybe you know that twin flame is younger than them and maybe older than them and not having a baby or maybe there is a huge age gap between the pair of twin flame. So first of all the basic, the reminder of the basic, you know, twin flame are two body one soul. Okay, so don't forget about that. So whatever is yours on a physical level, energetically is also theirs. Okay, so yes, their money is yours, your money is also theirs. So you can think how rich you are. So don't worry, my point is not to get into that. We can also anyway going to touch on those finances and all those topic when I get into the life purpose energy. And my specialty is also into the expansion of life purpose energy, because I had taken my healing through my life purpose. I did not had any experience of like romance with neither with my false twin flame nor with my true twin flame. So all that experiences I had was with my life purpose. Like the more and more I engaged with my life purpose, I started clearing the path on my twin flame journey. So that's my way, that's my my process of twin flame union. Yours could be different, so that's absolutely fine. Okay, again, the breathlessness is coming from the upheaval. You can see it from the another video also. So I just cleared a block and I am upheaving. But I still want to share something, so I am here. So if you are scared that or if you have a fear and you are holding yourself back with a thought that your twin flame is not going to accept you because you have a baby, you know, because you know, in our culture, you know how it is, you know how that person is going to accept your baby and all that drama, and you can remember all those movies, how those you know, like your stepmother has tortured all those kids or stepfather has tortured all those kids. So release all that, you know, that's drama, that's absolutely drama, that's not the truth. Truth is love. You know, there are so many cases you can see where actually in reality you can see, you know, if you have met or not met. Like you can see parents who have actually adopted children, right? Like they love those adopted children like they love their own children. That's the truth that you can see in your real life. And in the TV or in the movies, you can see how it is. So okay, maybe there could be some cases, but I don't have any awareness like that in my consciousness. So I will stick to the truth. The truth is love. When you love your baby, and you need to understand your relationship with your baby on a soul level, okay? Because externally, if you see, it will look like, you know, you are a mother or a father to the baby. But on a soul level, you don't know on which hierarchy they are. It could be they are spiritually more conscious, like they are spiritually having more authority than you, or could be reverse, that we don't know. We don't know till the time actually the spirit grows and get into the karma, okay, get into the actually blossoming of the true nature. Till that time we'll not get to know. So the only thing is we need to understand whoever we have around us and who are actually contributing a lot, like they have a big role in our part, in our day-to-day life. like for example your family has the closest influence on you, then your friends have influence on you, then you have your relatives, they have influence on you. Okay, so maybe you like them or you don't like them, but they keep playing their roles, right? So it's okay. And then you have your colleagues. Don't think that, you know, I have a professional life and then have a personal life, but you know, you are the one who is there in professional life and in personal life. So if you have a thought that you are different, then you are playing a game with yourself, that you know, you are different in the professional life and then there is a difference in your personal life. That means you are playing game with yourself. You are not authentically expressing what you are in like all the spaces. So maybe that's a different area of healing, not going there now. So the point is, when you have a baby, specifically your children have the maximum influence on your soul journey. Okay, like for any major choices, any major choices that you are going to make in your life, I will give you example. So any major choice that you want to take in your twin flame journey, it is only like it is your child who is going to be most influenced both way. Like he will be influenced and he is going to influence your choice. Okay, and know the role of God here. Okay, know the role of God. Why would God give you this situation where you have to choose separation? Okay, separation mean that you are choosing to be separate from your child. Like if you have a belief, like you have to separate from your child to be with your twin flame, or you are consciously choosing to stay away from your twin flame because you have a child. In both the cases, the energy is separation. Okay, so and you know, separation energy doesn't support your union. So if you are really seeking a harmonious union, so this kind of separation is like choice of separation is not going to help you. There is always a way out. Maybe there are like 1,000 different reasoning you might be having now and for which you are not able to move forward. I will request you to surrender everything and ask God to give you the perfect choice. You can take support, it's absolutely okay. Don't torture yourself, take the support, make it easy. Life is not a struggle. Life is not at all a struggle. It's always going to be easy when you are going to take the support, when you are not able to crack it by yourself. So the whole fundamental is your child is actually a cooperative component in your twin flame journey. And they have a purpose with your union. And they actually are going to contribute harmoniously in your twin flame union. Okay, so now I'm going to share with you my story. So my story, I was married and I was with a life of womanhood up to 35, and then when I got to know about my divine masculinity, and then I realized, you know, why I had the experience of marriage and why I had the baby. So it was, you know, there was always a deepest desire within me to have my baby, okay, to have my baby. And then I always had a desire to have a second baby, but due to some medical challenges, I cannot have a second baby. So I actually experienced the second baby scenario with my false twin flames, like both of my false twin flame and also my true twin flame. Okay, so now you can see it has always contributed positively, because the more you accept the baby, because first thing you need to identify the desire is there, that's why it is manifesting. So stop playing the game that there is something wrong happening. Nothing wrong happening, it's your desire. Maybe now you cannot acknowledge that's your desire because you are in pain by seeing that your harmonious union is delayed, but the truth is it's your desire that's manifesting. Okay, So start from there and let's see where God is taking you. So it's absolutely your desire, that's why the baby is there. So I always had a desire of two babies, okay? So that's why I experienced those, healing with, I experienced those feelings with my false twin flames, and then I experienced that peacefully with my true twin flame. Okay, and then as I am getting into harmonious union with a same sex union, it is going to be a same sex union. So it's very natural that biologically will not be able to give birth to baby, but you can see how God has taken care of this desire very peacefully, right? Like both of our, we are going to be in harmonious union and we'll have our child, like our own child. And I always had a desire to have my own child, and it is like my twin flame's child is my child. Okay, so claim it, you will have more clarity as you go ahead. But at this moment, what you need when you are going through this contrast, and if you are feeling that you have lost something, there is nothing that you lose. There is, what is yours is yours. Absolutely. What is yours is yours. So trust God, accept yourself. Thank you.